What happens if a firm is not registered? Now, the things are different in English law and things are different in the Indian law. English law is not as severe as the Indian law. Though Indian law has been derived from the English law, and these acts also were made while we were ruled by British, but now there is some distinction, there is some dissimilarity between the two as far as non-registration is concerned. English law is not very punitive or severe if there is no registration. However, Indian law is very severe on the firm and the partners if the registration is not done. Let's see what are the disabilities that a firm gets if it does not get registered. What are the rights which are taken away from it? Let's see. First, no suit in a civil court by firm or partners against the third party. Now, if the firm wants to put up a case against some third party, it cannot file a suit. Since it is unregistered, there is no legal person which is in existence. How can he file a suit if he is not in existence? So an unregistered can never file a suit against any third person. Even the partners of the firm for the business of the firm cannot file a suit against third parties, let's say debtors or creditors, people like these. A government, no suit would be entertained by the courts if the firm is unregistered. Second, no relief to partners for set off claim exceeding rupees 100. This is rupees 100. Now, what do you mean by set off? Set off means cancelling. Okay, so let's say you have to pay me 100 and I have to pay you 500. So what I'll do is I'll claim a set off for 100 and then pay you net 400. Now, why did I pay you net 400? Because I claimed a set off. Otherwise, what would have happened is you would have paid me 100 and I would have paid you 500. So the total outflow from my side is 500 minus 100, that is 400. And total inflow at your end is you get 500 and then you pay me 100. So total inflow is 400. Okay. So net net, you get 400, I pay 400. So what we do is we settle 400 only. But what we have done in the background is we have claimed a set off, a cancellation of 100 rupees. It was mutually payable and receivable. I also had to pay you 100, you also had to pay me 100. So we cancelled that debt and the remaining 400 I paid. So now, the partners, if one partner has to receive from the other partner, or if one partner has to receive from some other party, let's say, 5,000 rupees, he cannot claim a set off. Let's say he has to pay him 500 rupees and the other party has to pay him 5,000 rupees. Now, a claim of set off of rupees 500 cannot be done. Only 100 rupees can be set off. In short, if there are two persons who need to pay each other different amounts, let's say this person has to pay this person 1,000 rupees and this person has to pay him 900 rupees. So what should they be doing? Net net, this person should be giving him 100 rupees. But now if the firm is unregistered, let's say this was a partner, now he cannot claim a set off of more than 100. he can set off 100 and the remaining 900 he'll have to pay. Okay, and then he may receive 800 or whatever, the amount from this party. That is a different matter. But he cannot claim a set off of more than 100 rupees. Setting off is just cancelling. So debts cannot be cancelled. If I owe you something and then, I have given you loan also, that cannot be cancelled against each other exceeding rupees 100. Till 100 you can cancel the debt. More than 100 you cannot cancel. So set off is cancelling. Next, aggrieved partner cannot bring legal action against other partners of the firm. Even the partners within themselves cannot file a suit against each other. Even if there are disputes, even if, let's say, somebody has defrauded, they cannot file a case against each other as long as there is no criminal liability. If there's a murder or there's been smuggling or some law has been broken, only in that case a suit can be filed. Otherwise, in civil wrongs, in cases of torts, the partners cannot file cases against each other if the firm is unregistered. If the firm is registered, they can very well do it. But this is a disability if your firm is not registered. If you want to, if you have some amount that you have to receive from other partner, and if he's not paying you, you cannot file a suit against him if your firm is unregistered. And if there's some money which you have to receive from other partner of your firm, you cannot file a suit against him. Okay? Now there are some rights which are not affected by non-registration. Let's see what are those rights. First, right of the third party to sue the firm. Now we said the firm cannot sue the third party for the debts. But this does not affect the right of third party to sue the firm. The third party can always sue you. Your supplier can always sue you. You may not be able to sue your debtor, but supplier can always file a suit against you. This does not affect his right. Okay. Second, right of a partner to sue for dissolution of the firm. If he wants to apply for dissolution, then he may very well put up a case in the court. Account settlement, if there is some settlement of account pending, let's say he wants to retire, and then the accounts are not being settled, he may sue for account settlement. Realization of dissolved firm's property. If the firm is being dissolved, but the partners are not willing to sell off the property. Realization means selling off, realizing in cash, realizing cash out of assets. So in short, realizing means selling off. So selling off firm's property in case of dissolved firm. The firm is dissolved and the partners are not willing to sell off the properties, he may put up the case against other partners. So in these cases, the partner can sue the other partners. Otherwise, one partner cannot sue other partner. And finally, the power of official assignee or receiver of court. Who is the official assignee? Official assignee is a person appointed by court. To realize assets of firm and pay off its debts. Now, what happens is many times when the matter of dissolution is sub judice, that is, it goes to the court. in those cases, the court appoints a person known as official assignee or the receiver of the court. That means he will be entitled to sell off the assets of the firm. Though he is not the owner of the firm, though he is not the partner in the firm, but he gets the right to sell off the assets of the firm, and whatever cash he realizes, he pays off the debts of the firm. So this is the function of, this is the duty of official assignee or receiver of the court. But you know, if the firm is unregistered, this does not affect his right. He can still take the property of the firm in his custody and then sell it off. The firm won't be able to do anything. The non-registration of the firm does not affect his right. Whose right? The right of official assignee or official liquidator or official receiver of the court. Okay. Lastly, right to sue or set off suits not more than 100. We've already discussed this. You can set off claims and, you know, debts till 100 rupees. I have to give you 100 rupees, you have to give me 100 rupees, we set it off. You have to give me 200 rupees, I need to give you 200 rupees, we can only set off claims of 100 rupees. Remaining 100 rupees will have to be settled. You know, so any claims, any debts which are more than 100 rupees cannot be set off. But till 100 rupees, you can set it off.